Mr. Nithya Kripakaran, sir. And I would like to invite Mr. Nithya Kripakaran, sir, to the stage. And Mr. Nithya Kripakaran completed his graduation in commerce from Bangalore University and subsequently graduated in bachelor's for medical record science from Christian Medical College Hospital, Vellore, affiliated to Dr. MGR Medical University, Chennai. He was instrumental in organizing and managing the medical records department in Meenakshi Mission Hospital and Research Center, Madurai, Kovai Medical Center and Hospital, Coimbatore and Amrita Institute of Medical Sciences, Kochi. He trained many medical records professionals who are currently employed in different hospitals in India and abroad. After 2 decades, he came to Abu Dhabi. He was in NMC Healthcare and the largest private healthcare organization in UAE. Presently, he is the senior manager, medical records department at NMC Royal Hospital, Abu Dhabi. So I welcome Mr. Nithya Kripakaran sir to present his section. And his section name is Strategies for Effective EHR Transition at Integrated Healthcare Systems. Sir.
Namaskaram, Kerala, God's own country. Next, what I will say, my own people. Though I was born in Karnataka, studied in Tamil Nadu, last 20 years, I was working with Kerala and Keralites. So that is the reason I say, you are my own people. Okay, my presentation is little different. It is not about data or it is not about coding. I'll be talking about the realities of implementing electronic medical records. As the medical records professionals, what are all the challenges you'll be facing in implementing medical records, electronic medical records? Okay, this is the agenda. Introduction to medical records, the problems of paper records, advantages and disadvantages of EMR, some of the EMR screenshots, strategies for effective transition, and problems encountered. So what are medical records is? First, a medical record should contain sufficient data to identify the patient. What is the name, age, gender, and it should be compiled in a timely manner, support the diagnosis, the past history, present complaints, and the investigation results. If you correlate, it should support the diagnosis, justify the treatment, what you are giving, and accurately document the results. So what is the purpose? If it is not documented, it is not done. So a medical record should accurately and adequately document the patient's life and health history, including past and present illnesses and treatments, events affecting the patient during the current episode of care. So what is the history? Traditionally, all medical records are maintained on paper called charts. Typically, a patient has several charts, each maintained at different locations. So you must have heard my biodata. I worked in 5 different hospitals, and each hospital is having my medical records. So what are all the problems? These are all the problems what you encounter on a day-to-day basis. So this is what, when a proper medical records is maintained from birth till death, and this is how a medical records looks. So what are electronic medical records? Medical information compiled in a data gathering format for retention and transfer of protected information via a secured encrypted communication line. The information can be readily stored onto an acceptable storage medium such as a compact disk. What a complete EMR. So all these days we were talking, if doctor's orders, prescriptions and the investigations are there in the computer, it is complete. And today we started talking, it is from cradle to grave, birth to death. And tomorrow we may talk, it is from prenatal to postmortem. So what, how it has happened? Electronic medical records did not happen overnight. When you see last 20 years or 30 years, it started with microfilming. Some of the people who studied with me in CMC Vellore, they must have had the opportunity to see what is that microfilming and Broadma, all those things. Then came scanning, transcription, now data entry and computer interfacing. So what are all the advantages? Consistent. The information which is entered in the electronic medical records, it is consistent, it is flexible. A patient goes to a doctor with a paper record. If that doctor refers that patient to another doctor, the medical record has to be going with the patient. But in electronic medical records, the other doctor, referred doctor, can see the medical record, so it is flexible. Problem-oriented approach, machine-assisted decision-making, quality assurance, and remote access. So these are all the 7 stages of EMR. I am not going to in detail. All these things are available in the net. So these are all some of the EMR in which I was involved. This is from Amrita. So one best thing what we did in Amrita is, whenever any person views the record, apart from patient care, this is what we ask them. Why do you want to access the record? So this history is automatically, it is saved in the back end. So the next screen will be the information about the patient, where you'll have all the details, and about the complete history of the patient, how many visits and what is the diagnosis, all those things. And this is another EMR in which I was part. This is called as Backbone, where you'll find everything in a single sheet, like vitals, a review visit, walk, all those things can be seen. Then all the medications, what the patient is taking, the prescription, the diagnosis, or if anything, sometimes all the doctors may not be computer savvy. Everybody may not be entering directly in the computer. Some people will be still writing in the piece of paper. So how it can be scanned and uploaded in the same system. And some of the investigations, ECG, PFD, all those things can be scanned and uploaded in the system. Patient comes, you want to involve the patient in the treatment process. Like you want to show him how his blood values or how his investigation reflected in the past 6 months. So with a simple graph or single dashboard, you can explain to the patient. And this is an EMR from my wife's hospital, pediatric department, outpatient EMR, how the history of the patient or the growth of the patient is can be put in the graph. Then how it can be, like disadvantages of EMR. The main thing most of us see is in a small hospital or a medium scale hospital, startup cost, how much will be the cost? The technical knowledge, reliability, accountability, and every time we talk about confidentiality, how confidential the information in EMR, security, and lack of common vision. In Abu Dhabi, this issue we are facing now. In Abu Dhabi, we are going for a Malafi, where the patient will have his own record, and all the hospital can see. The main issue is different hospital have their own system and own platform. How to bring everything together in one system? So this is what, in a small country like Abu Dhabi, it is an issue. You think about India, with such a vast area, with such a, so many hospitals from primary to tertiary care, how it can be linked together. So this is what happened. Patient is waiting outside, computer is gone, better call technical support, the darn EMR crashed again. So this is the requirement. A proper medical records department, how we are going to convert into a electronic medical records department. So what are all the steps you need to take? First, you need to have a clear-cut objectives. What you want to do? Whether you want to have only the prescription or doctor's order, or you want to have complete thing in the system, or only you want outpatient, or you want both outpatient or inpatient. Clear-cut objective should be there. Meticulous planning, how you are going to plan, stage by stage. Overnight it cannot happen. It will take its own time. Meticulous planning. Project, proper project management. What happens most of the time? We give to the vendors and they start guiding us. We don't involve in the project management. And sufficient staffing and good supplier performance and support. What are all the questions to be answered during the transition? Should an unsigned document be visible in EMR? Whether a document created by a resident made available in the system to view before the consultant signs it off? Should a resident be allowed to authenticate a document? This is what practically happening. Consultant will give their username and password, and most of the time you may say, no, we are not doing. But this is what happened. The residents will be using the password and they will be authenticating the document. Whether users permitted to take printout of unfinished document, should the patients and the third party administrator be allowed to access the EMR? Precautions to be taken after transition. Users are required to have complex passwords which should be changed periodically. All logins and viewed data are recorded and reviewed to minimize the occurrence of unauthorized access. Using a centralized database allows the computer and data to be physically secured and backup taken on a regular basis. Sensitive printouts with identifiable patient data are shredded and discarded. So what are all the user problems? Lack of user training. What happens? A vendor comes, he gives the presentation, the management is happy about the EMR without any training. Next month, we are going live. No training, lack of user training. Poor initial design. Most of the time, we don't go for the shoes for our leg. We try to cut our leg for the shoes. Since most of the system which is available in the market, they ask us to adopt to their system. Poor initial design. System difficult to use or too complex. Lack of involvement of users in designing and testing. Designing, no way. At least in testing, the users, the medical record professionals, should be involved in EMR. Lack of system and staff training to ensure data quality and completeness. From morning we are talking quality of data. But unless you have a proper system in place, you will not be able to retrieve a quality data. Lack of perceived benefits for users. Dependence of one individual EMR champion. Practically what happens? You have about five doctors in a department and one doctor is very interested in computer, always in his mobile. So what you will do? You will make him as a EMR champion. So that fellow will learn, and finally, when he gets a better chance, he will go. Whatever the training you have given to him, finished. Then you have find out next person training to adapt to the system. Technical problem. Lack of manual backup system in the event of computer network failure. When the computer is gone, what is the backup system? Now maybe JCI is talking about it. What is the backup system you have? In case, if the computer goes off, how you are going to manage, how you are going to treat the patient? We have started writing the SOPs for those things. Poor system security leading to virus and spyware. Unstable, and this maybe recently in the group I passed a message, how the data was leaked. Indian, so many medical records of Indians were leaked. Unstable power supplies and lack of battery backup. In a small country like Abu Dhabi, we can say 24 hours current is available. And in India, what is going to happen? Morning, I was with a blazer, and now I cannot wear the blazer. So what happens? Then only I saw Mujib, why he was wearing a simple shirt like that. So poor or inadequate data backup. Lack of technical support staff both in software and hardware team. Something happens, like you have 40 clinics and there will be about 5 or 6 technical people. And something happens, it happens in all the clinics. The call will come to medical records from all the clinic. You call the technical person, there will be 1 or 2. And what they will say? You send a mail. You send a mail, you will get a ticket. When the ticket will be closed, if he goes on weekly off or if he is on leave, the ticket will be closed. Whether the problem is solved? No, it will not be solved. So that's the practical problem what we face when we implement EMR. Legal acceptance, still a question mark. Clinical trials and organ transplantation, still they want the paper records. Informed consent, we are trying to have some electronic signature. Consultation record, request is done by one junior doctor. He does it in electronic, and the reply is done by a senior doctor. Still he wants to do it paper record. So reply and request is not there. Scanning, what to do with the paper records. Whether the government allows us to discard the records, paper records, still it is a question mark. Partial implementation. Some hospital, they implement in OP and they don't implement in IP. Some hospital, they implement in IP, they don't implement in OP, depending upon the crowd. So there is no continuity. Machine interfacing. So many old ECG machines are there, PFT machines are there. And management will not change all the machines to a i5 machine overnight. It will take some stages. So till that time, whatever the documents you need to scan and upload. Dual registration, one of the biggest problem. In Abu Dhabi, in government sector, when they wanted to implement EMR, there was a team hired from India. They were just seeing the dual registration and they were merging the records. That's the main thing they were doing, dual registration. Patient load, personal touch or contact is lost. Medical and nursing staff turnover. Today they are here, tomorrow one new hospital comes up, they go away. Medical staff turnover. So conclusion, implementing electronic medical records is worthwhile, but can be painful and laborious in the beginning. Because putting down the paper and pen and picking up the mouse and keyboard involves a cultural shift and it cannot happen overnight, it will take time. So you know I have twin daughters, my elder daughter this year completed engineering and younger daughter completed medicine. And most of you were asking what your twin daughters are doing. This is what, the update. Bye, take care. Any questions? You are the right person, sir, to answer that question. Yeah. I am foreign. Since you are in India, you are the right person to answer that question. Yeah, in foreign it is accepted because it's a small country and everyone wants to adopt to EMR, so it is accepted. In India, it is a long way. Now only, like for example, in the one of Mr. Sabu's slide, he mentioned that EMR standard was adopted in 2012. But still, how long we have come? 8 years are over. I think definitely it will be accepted in future. As of now, it is a question mark.